Yesterday we discussed mainly about religion and the different religion in Indian context, the general characteristics of them. Today we will mainly focus on the Hinduism. We'll try to know in comprehensive way. And for discussion on this very topic, we have in studio the same resource person, Dr. Amit Sharma. He teaches sociology at a school of social science in Jawaharlal Nehru University. So on your behalf, I welcome Dr. Sharma for a set lecture on this very topic, religion. Welcome you, sir.
Thank you. Today I will speak about the Hindu religion or Hinduism. The term Hindu is not an Indian term. It is a Persian term. And actually, in the Persian language, they are not trying to pronounce the term Hindu. Persian language and Sanskrit language are very similar languages. They are complementary languages. And Persian civilization and Indian civilization are also complementary. Therefore, the term which the Persians are trying to pronounce is Sindhu. But in Persian language, there is no alphabet which connotes or echoes like sa. Therefore, what is Sindhu for Indians becomes Hindu for the Persians, and it becomes Hindu for the Greeks. Therefore, Sindhu, Hindu and Hindu, these are one term pronounced differently in three different languages, namely Sanskrit, that is Sindhu, Hindu, that is Persian, and Hindu, that is Greek. From Hindu, it became Indus, and from Indus, it became Indian in English. Therefore, the term Hindu is a geocultural concept. It is not a religious concept. When the Persians referred to the term Hindu, they were referring to a geocultural concept. They were trying to say that we are referring to the culture of those who live on the bank of Sindhu. Now the term Sindhu in Sanskrit has two meanings. One is the river Sindhu or Indus, and second is ocean. Sindhu also means ocean, the Indian Ocean, the Hind Mahasagar. Therefore, in the original conceptualization, the term Hindu is a geocultural concept. It is a cultural concept, it is a civilizational concept. But what was the religion of those who lived in India or Bharat? It was called Sanatan Dharma. Now what is Sanatan Dharma? Which has no beginning and which will have no end. Therefore, this is a perennial religion. This perennial religion was not found only in India. It was found in ancient Persia, ancient Babylonia, ancient Mesopotamia, ancient Maya and Inca, ancient Egypt, ancient Greece, and ancient Rome. Usually, outside India, these religions are conceptualized today as pagan religions, or religions which existed prior to the Semitic religions. Yesterday we have seen that Semitic religions are three religions: Judaism, Christianity, and Islam. Therefore, pagan religions are those religions which were found all over the world before these Semitic religions. Now, when the Europeans came to India to study it as a civilization, they called Sanatan Dharma the Vedic religion, because Rig Veda is the first book written in India, and today it is accepted by almost every important scholars of religion that Vedas are the first book of the world. There is no book which dates prior to the Rig Veda. Vedas are four: Rig Veda, Yajurveda, Samaveda, and Atharva Vedas. These four Vedas are complementary to each other. Now, Vedas are called Shruti. Shruti is something which is heard. Therefore, Vedas were not written books in the beginning. The Quran, the Bible, both the New Testament and the Old Testament are written books. They are finite books. But Vedas are not finite books, not written books. These are Shrutis. And these are paramparik. The term parampara in Sanskrit is usually translated as tradition in English language. Many scholars, including Anand Kentis Kumar Swami, Marco Pallis, René Guénon, Count Kesselring, and many others have opined that the term parampara and the term tradition, these are not one and the same thing. As we have seen yesterday, the term religion and the term dharma are not one and the same. Tradition is something which is associated with trade. Tradition is something which is understood as a sum total of cultural values which is handed down from one generation to the other generation. But parampara is something else. In Sanskrit, the vak, that is language, is divided into four parts. One is para, the other is pasyanti, the third is madhyama, the fourth is vaikhari. The vaikhari language or the vaikhari vak is the one which is spoken. Therefore, what I am speaking to you is vaikhari. What is madhyama? Madhyama is not spoken, but it is symbolically expressed. Therefore, poetry is madhyama, myth is madhyama, dream is madhyama. Then there is pasyanti. Now, pasyanti is also not spoken like madhyama, but there is a difference. The difference is that madhyama is neither prose nor poetry. It is mantras. Now, what is mantra? मंत्रा कैन बी रफली कॉन्सेप्चुलाइज एज फॉर्मूला ऑफ व्हाट, फॉर्मूला ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन. मंत्राज आर फॉर्मूलाज टू कम्युनिकेट विथ द डिवाइन पावर्स. थ्रू मंत्रा ए पर्सन ट्राइज टू कम्युनिकेट विथ गॉड एंड गॉडेसेस. देयरफॉर वेदाज आर रिटन इन पश्यंती लैंग्वेज. बट व्हाट इज परा? परा कैनॉट बी कम्युनिकेटेड टू दी अदर वेरी इजिली. इट इज अनस्पोकन लैंग्वेज एंड इट इज कम्युनिकेटेड वेरी डिफरेंटली टू दी अदर. वैखरी इज प्रोज, मध्यमा इज पोएट्री, पश्यंती इज मंत्रा एंड परा इज समथिंग विच इज बियॉन्ड एक्सप्रेशन इन दी ऑर्डिनरी लैंग्वेज एंड इट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू कम्युनिकेट इन इंग्लिश. द ओनली टर्म विच द इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज हैड इज इंट्यूशन और टेलीपैथिक कम्युनिकेशन. वट इज टेलीपैथी? देर आर टू पर्सन सिटिंग इन टू डिफरेंट प्लेसेस एंड देर इज नो मीडियम ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन. वन थिंग्स एंड द अदर अंडरस्टैंड विदाउट एनी मीडियम. इट इज कॉल्ड टेलीपैथी. टू पर्सन्स हैव सिमिलर आइडियाज एट द सेम टाइम विदाउट कम्युनिकेटिंग टू ईच अदर. नाउ परंपरा इज रूटेड इन परा वाक और परा लैंग्वेज. इट इज समथिंग लाइक द टर्म पाराडाइम इन नेचुरल साइंसेस. यू मस्ट हैव हर्ड दैट इन साइंसेस देयर आर पाराडाइम्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल न्यूटोनियन पैराडाइम, कोपरनिकस एंड न्यूटन एंड आइंस्टाइन. दिस थ्री इंपॉर्टेंट पीपुल हैव प्रोड्यूस्ड पैराडाइम शिफ्ट इन द लैंग्वेज ऑफ फिजिक्स. इन द सेम वे पारा इज पैराडिग्मेटिक. इट इज समथिंग विच मेक्स कम्युनिकेशन पॉसिबल. इट इज बियॉन्ड द रीच ऑफ द ऑर्डिनरी लैंग्वेज बट इट इज समथिंग विच मेक्स कम्युनिकेशन पॉसिबल सम हाउ. एंड वाट इज दैट सम हाउ? दैट इज कॉल्ड परंपरा. परंपरा लिंक्स people of one civilization to each other at all three levels, conscious, subconscious and unconscious. Therefore, Sanatan Dharma in India and the pagan religions elsewhere, they were very different to each other. I will give one example. You must have heard that in Egypt, in ancient Egypt, there were and there are pyramids. Pyramids are architectural monuments of very unique variety. But scholars of Egyptian civilization have not been able to understand what are the sources of these architectural monuments. In Egyptian civilization, there is no clue how these monuments were made. But in case you wanted to understand how pyramids were made, there are books in Indian civilization. These are called Sulbh Sutras. On the basis of Sulbh Sutras, you can understand the mathematical precision of architectural designs of the pyramids. What is the implication? The implication is that the ancient Egyptian civilization and ancient Indian civilization were related to each other. In the same way, in India, we will have Vedas. And in ancient Persian civilization, there was a book called the Avesta. It is supposed to be written by Zoroaster. Now, the Rig Vedas and Avesta, they are related to each other, both in language as well as in content. In the same way, ancient Greek iconography cannot be appreciated fully without understanding the theories of art in Sanskrit. In the same way, ancient Romans used to worship the sun god on 25th of December before the Romans became Christian in 4th century AD. 25th December was regarded as the birthday of Lord Sun in ancient Rome. Later on, it was transformed to be the birthday of Jesus Christ, because Jesus was regarded as the only Son of God. Sun and moon, they are regarded as the two principal symbols of divinity. They were regarded as the two important gods, and interestingly, sun is regarded as male, moon is regarded as female. Therefore, the Sanatan Dharma is the foundation of the Hindu culture, Hindu civilization, Indic civilization. Today we will discuss some of the important features of this Sanatan Dharma or Hinduism or Hindu religion. The first principle of Sanatan Dharma is that there are two important principles about the creation. One is considered as Agni or fire, and the representative of Agni or fire is sun god. The other is water or pani or som. एंड द सिंबॉलिक रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ सोम इज मून गॉड और मून गॉडेस. व्हेन सन एंड मून आर सिंथेसाइज्ड टुगेदर दे आर इमर्जेज ए गॉड हु इज नोन एज शिवा. शिवा इज अर्धनारीश्वर. वी हैव सीन स्टडी शिवा इज ए कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ सन एंड मून. शिवा इज ए कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ फायर एंड वाटर. यू मस्ट हैव सीन दैट इन शिवा टेम्पल्स वाटर इज पोर्ड ओवर द गॉड शिवा. यू ऑल्सो मस्ट हैव नोटेड दैट दोज हु वर्शिप लॉर्ड सन पोर वाटर टू द सन गॉड. वाई? बिकॉज ऑफ ए सीक्रेट विच इज कम्युनिकेटेड फ्रॉम वन जेनरेशन टू द अदर जेनरेशन. एंड वाट इज दैट सीक्रेट? दैट वेयर एवर लॉर्ड शिवा इज वर्शिप्ड दैट एरिया इज प्रोन टू फ्लड. आई एम गिविंग यू सम एग्जाम्पल्स. लॉर्ड शिवा इज वर्शिप्ड इन नेपाल एंड इन द रेनी सीजन्स नेपाल इज फ्लडेड. लॉर्ड शिवा इज वर्शिप्ड इन ईस्टर्न यूपी द सेंटर ऑफ विच इज वाराणसी काशी एंड ईस्टर्न यूपी इज फ्लडेड. लॉर्ड शिवा इज वर्शिप्ड इन अनडिवाइडेड बिहार एट देवघर देयर इज वैद्यनाथ. एट काठमांडू देयर इज पशुपतिनाथ. एट वाराणसी देयर इज विश्वनाथ. एंड इन ऑल दीज थ्री नेपाल ईस्टर्न उत्तर प्रदेश एंड बिहार अनडिवाइडेड बिहार. दिस इज प्राइमरली द लैंड वेयर शिवा इज वर्शिप्ड एंड दिस इज यूजुअली फ्लडेड टूडे. देन यू गो टू बेंगाल. हु इज वर्शिप्ड इन बेंगाल? हु इज द प्राइमरी डेइटी? काली. हु इज काली? द वाइफ ऑफ लॉर्ड शिवा. एंड नेपाल ईस्टर्न यूपी एंड बिहार इज एक्सटेंडेड टू वेस्ट बंगाल एंड आसाम ऑल्सो. वेस्ट बंगाल इज ऑल्सो फ्लडेड. द सेम इज ट्रू ऑफ आसाम अनडिवाइडेड आसाम द नॉर्थ ईस्ट. यू नो दैट चेरापूंजी विच इज सिचुएटेड इन मेघालय टूडे रिसीव्स द मैक्सिमम रेनफॉल. And in Kamakhya temple of Assam, Shakti is worshipped. Kamakhya Devi is the wife of Lord Shiva. Therefore, wherever Lord Shiva is worshipped, there is flood and affluence of water. It is dominated by Soma Tattva, that is water. Now come to the other way. Wherever Lord Vishnu or his avatars are worshipped, you will find that either there is paucity of water or there is desert or sandy sour water. For example, in Rajasthan, Sri Krishna is worshipped. And you find that Rajasthan consists of deserts. Water is very little poured by the rain god in Rajasthan. Then Lord Krishna is worshipped at Mathura, Vrindavan, and you will find that the water is not sweet in Mathura and Vrindavan. It is sour. It is not a very good drinking water. In the same way, Lord Krishna is worshipped in Gujarat. Gujarat also consists of deserts. Then, Lord Jagannath, an incarnation of Lord Krishna, is worshipped in Orissa. And you find places like Kalahandi in Orissa. Orissa also receives very little rainfall in comparison to the Shaivite area. What I am trying to say is that Lord Vishnu and his incarnations represent sun or fire. And Shiva and Shakti, they represent water and Som. Som and Agni, Agni and Som, these are the two principles of the Vedas. There are two important kulas of rishis. One is called Bhrigu Kula or Bhrigu Parampara, and the other is called Angira Parampara. Rishi Angira is the primary rishi of Agni Vidya. And Rishi Bhrigu is the primary rishi of the Som Vidya or Sanjivani Vidya. Now, Angira was followed by Brihaspati or Jupiter. And Bhrigu was followed by Shukracharya or Venus. Jupiter and Venus, that is Brihaspati and Shukracharya, they are regarded as the two advisors or two mantris, two ministers, two gurus of Lord Sun, who is the king. Now, what is the Agni Vidya? Agni Vidya is the Hindu physics. What is the Som Vidya? Som Vidya is the Hindu biology. What is common to physics and biology? Chemistry. And even today, chemistry is divided into two parts. The physical chemistry and the organic chemistry. The physical chemistry is like physics, and organic chemistry is like biology. At least they are linked. And in all ancient civilizations, there was a vidya or knowledge called alchemy. The modern world does not know much about alchemy or alchemistry. What I wanted to stress is that वेदिक रिलीजन इज नॉट रिलीजन लाइक क्रिश्चियनिटी, इस्लाम और जुडाइज्म. वैदिक रिलीजन इज लाइक मॉडर्न साइंस. इट इज बेस्ड ऑन फॉर्मूलाज, इट इज बेस्ड ऑन मैथमेटिकल फॉर्मूलाज एंड लॉजिकल फॉर्मूलाज. इट इज बेस्ड ऑन रीजनिंग. दिस इज बेस्ड ऑन साइंस. एंड यू विल बी सरप्राइज टू नो दैट द मोस्ट सेक्रेड वेदाज आर रिगार्डेड एज अविद्या. एंड उपनिषदाज आर रिगार्डेड एज विद्याज. वॉट इज विद्या? विद्या इज दैट नॉलेज विच लिबरेट्स यू फ्रॉम द वर्ल्ड. वेदाज डू नॉट लिबरेट यू फ्रॉम द वर्ल्ड. वेदाज गिव यू नॉलेज, थ्योरी, मेथड एंड टेक्निक टू अंडरस्टैंड द वर्ल्ड, टू अंडरस्टैंड द यूनिवर्स, टू अंडरस्टैंड द कॉस्मोस. दे ऑल्सो गिव यू थ्योरी, मेथड एंड टेक्निक टू कंट्रोल द वर्ल्ड, टू मैनेज द वर्ल्ड, टू डेवलप द वर्ल्ड द वे यू वॉन्ट. ऑन द अदर हैंड, वेदांता और उपनिषद्स, ब्रह्म सूत्र एंड श्रीमद् भगवत गीता, दीज थ्री आर रिगार्डेड एज वेदांता. द ब्रह्म सूत्र वाज रिटन बाई वादरायन. उपनिषद्स आर पार्ट्स ऑफ द वेदाज बट दे हैव इंडिपेंडेंट एंटिटी ऑफ देयर ओन एज वेल. एंड भगवत गीता इज ए चैप्टर इन द सेक्शन कॉल्ड शांति पर्व ऑफ द ग्रेट इपिक महाभारता. दीज थ्री ब्रह्मसूत्रा, उपनिषद्स एंड द भगवत गीता आर कॉल्ड और एज रेफर्ड टू एज प्रस्थान त्रयी. एंड एवरी इंपॉर्टेंट हिंदू आचार्य हैज रिटन कमेंट्री ऑन इट. द कमेंट्री रिटन बाई आदि शंकराचार्य इज कॉल्ड अद्वैत वेदांता. द कमेंट्री रिटन बाई रामानुजाचार्य ऑन दीज थ्री इज कॉल्ड एज विशिष्टाद्वैत. एंड द कमेंट्री रिटन बाई मध्वाचार्य इज कॉल्ड द्वैताद्वैत. बट इट इज नॉट द एंड. वेन द ब्रिटिश केम इन इंडिया दे रिड्यूस्ड प्रस्थान त्रयी टू वन. दे डिस्कार्डेड द ब्रह्म सूत्राज, दे डिस्कार्डेड द उपनिषद्स एंड यूलोजाइज द भगवत गीता. दे सेड दैट एज द क्रिश्चियंस हैव द बाइबल एंड द मुस्लिम्स हैव द कुरान, इन द सेम वे हिंदूज हैव द भगवत गीता. सम इंग्लिश एजुकेटेड स्कॉलर्स ऑफ इंडिया बिकेम फैसिनेटेड बाई इट एंड दे रोट कमेंट्री ऑन द भगवत गीता. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, बाल गंगाधर तिलक और तिलक महाराज रोट गीता रहस्य. महात्मा गांधी रोट हिज कमेंट्री ऑन गीता. इट इज ट्रांसलेटेड इन टू इंग्लिश एज द गॉस्पेल ऑफ वर्क. इन द सेम वे श्री अरविंदो रोट हिज कमेंट्री ऑन भगवत गीता. ओशो रजनीश हैज ऑल्सो रिटन हिज कमेंट्री ऑन भगवत गीता एंड स्वामी अड़गड़ानंद हु इज अलाइव टूडे हैज रिटन यथार्थ गीता. स्वामी चिन्मयानंद ऑल्सो रोट हिज कमेंट्री ऑन भगवत गीता बट आई टीच सोशियोलॉजी ऑफ रिलीजन. आई नो वाट इज द ट्रूथ, वाट इज द हिस्ट्री. आई थिंक इट इज अ रॉन्ग वे ऑफ कॉन्सेप्चुलाइजिंग सनातन धर्म. हिंदूज डू नॉट हैव ए बुक ऑफ देयर ओन. इवन बी आर अंबेडकर न्यू इट. वेन इट वॉज आस्ट वाई बी आर अंबेडकर कन्वर्टेड टू बुद्धिज्म एंड नॉट टू क्रिश्चियनिटी और इस्लाम, ही सेड हैड आई कन्वर्टेड टू क्रिश्चियनिटी और इस्लाम माई फॉलोअर्स वुड हैव बीन डाइवोर्स्ड फ्रॉम द कल्चर ऑफ देयर फोर फादर्स. आई एम अगेंस्ट द हिंदू रिलीजन बट आई एम नॉट अगेंस्ट द हिंदू कल्चर. Therefore, I changed my religion, but I have not changed my culture. In the same way, Dr. Radhakrishnan was asked, what is Hinduism? He said, it is not a religion, it is a way of life. I also think that Hinduism is not a religion. It consists of many religions. Hinduism is a culture, it is a way of life, it is a civilization, it is a geocultural concept. And the most ancient form, the most early form of Hinduism was called Sanatan Dharma. Gandhiji was also a votary of Sanatan Dharma. For him, Hinduism is basically Sanatan Dharma. Now, Sanatan Dharma of the Vedas was transformed after Gautam the Buddha and Mahavir, Jain Mahavir. Now, what happened? The Vedic religion or Vedic Hinduism was not a missionary religion. But after Gautam Buddha, the Vedic religion became missionary in reaction to Buddhism. Great transformation took place after Gautam the Buddha. Why? Unlike Mahavir, who was the 24th Tirthankara of the Jains. Jainism was founded by Rishabhdev. Jainism is a very ancient religion of India. Mahavir was after Lord Krishna and before Lord Buddha. He codified the Jain Dharma or Jain religion. But Jainism could not develop Jain culture. They could not develop a Jain village. Rather, they maintained their identity within the Hindu culture, within the Hindu village, because culture requires different types of occupations. Lord Mahavir was born as a Kshatriya, but his followers became Vaisyas or traders, commercial people. All Jains usually follow commerce or Vanijya or Vyavasaya as their profession. No village can function only by one profession of traders. You need different type of people to maintain the village. The same is true about the Buddhists. But Buddhism is not found only in India. Buddhism is found in other places as well. Buddhism was successful in developing a culture of its own, at least outside India. And even in India, there were many kings who converted to Buddhism. Therefore, Buddhism became the first missionary religion of India. Now, what is Buddhism? You can understand Buddhism by a formula. Lord Krishna is the thesis. Lord Mahavir is the antithesis. And Buddha is the synthesis. What Krishna taught in the Bhagavad Gita or in Srimad Bhagavat, that devotion to God or bhakti or complete surrender to God is the path of salvation. But what Mahavir taught? Purusharth or karma, determined karma or sankalp is the way to salvation. And what Buddha taught? Knowledge or the middle path between Lord Krishna and Lord Mahavira is the path of salvation. Therefore, in Sanatan Dharma, there are three paths of salvation. One is called the Bhakti Marg, or the path of devotion, propounded by Lord Krishna. One is called the Karma Marg, or the path of action, propounded by Lord Mahavira. And third is Gyan Marg, or the path of knowledge propounded by Lord Buddha. But as you know, Lord Buddha said, I am not teaching something new. Rather, I am giving a new interpretation to the Sanatana Dharma. What was his new interpretation? Before Lord Gautam Buddha, Varnashram Dharma or Varna Vyavastha, Varna Ashram Vyavastha was regarded to be based on birth. Lord Buddha said, no, Varnas are based on inclination, basic inclination and performance. One is born as one people and they are regarded as Shudras. Everybody is born from the mother's womb as Shudras. And one becomes Brahmin, Kshatriya and Vaisya by Sanskaraj, by training, by education. Therefore, Brahmins, Kshatriyas and Vaisyas are known as Dvijaj. They are twice born. One takes the first birth from the womb of the mother, but one takes the second birth from the womb of the Guru. Therefore, in Buddhism, Varna Vyavastha is based on non biological factors. The children of a Brahmin father may not necessarily become Brahmin automatically. They will have to earn Brahminhood. One is a Brahmin only when he or she performs the Brahmin duty. In India, the right is less important than duty. Now, there has been a great debate about Varnashram Vyavastha in modern India as well. Mahatma Gandhi was against the caste system. He was against untouchability, but he was a great votary of Varnashram Dharma. He said Varnashram Dharma is relevant even today. Now, what is Varnashram Dharma? This is classification of the whole population into four parts. Brahmins, whose duty is to do research, do teaching and do guidance and counseling to the kings or the political leaders and the common people. Who are the Kshatriyas? Those who safeguard the territorial integrity of the nation and who help maintain law and order in society. Who are the Vaishyas? Vaishyas are not only traders, they are also agricultural people. Therefore, those who sustain the economic needs of society are called Vaishyas. And who are the Sudras? The Sudras are the professional people. The carpenters are engineers. The Lohars are the blacksmith are also engineers. The blacksmith or Lohar is the mechanical engineer. The Badhai or carpenter is the civil engineer. And Kumhar is also an engineer. Therefore, engineering and medicine is Sudra profession in Vedic lexicon. The only difference is that the Sudras have professional degrees. They have professional competence. They can serve society by their technical skill. But their duty to serve the society. Therefore, they are service-oriented people. They have professions, whereas the other three Varnas have vocations. There are minute differences between the four, and no Varna is inferior to each other, to any other. A Sudra is not inferior to Vaishya, Kshatriya or Brahmin. It is a wrong conception that Brahmins are superior and other Varnas are inferior. In Hindu society, it is said that everybody is equal. They have only different rights and duties. Therefore, Hindu society is not a hierarchical society as Louis Dumont says. Homo society is a society where equality is maintained by giving different spheres of rights and duties. I will stop here and invite questions and queries.
Okay. So as you said that Sudra has professional degree and they are serving the society. So if we compare it from the Vedic era, so this is the one difference. But the other way of explaining the caste system was to maintain a kind of a peace and harmony in the society. That was also the purpose, and that's why when we find that the number of invaders came into India during medieval times, we find a number of more number of castes. So how we explain that?
There is a debate in sociology. Basically, there are three schools. One school is represented by a professor who is no more with us now, G.S. Ghurye. He said that the caste emerged out of division in the Varna system. It is called the fission theory. That originally Varnas existed in Indian society and caste emerged out of the Varnas later on. This view is opposed by another sociologist called Iravati Karve, who said that castes are the original foundations of Hindu society and Varnas emerged later on by fusion of different castes into four Varnas. There is a third view which is represented by M.N. Srinivas and Andre Bete. Andre Bete is still alive, although Srinivas is dead. They say that originally Varnas are models, conceptual or intellectual models, and castes are empirical reality. Castes are found within the district. Caste is local phenomena. Varna are all India phenomena. Now my personal view is that the term caste, which is in India, in Indian languages called jati, is not found in any of the ancient text. The term jati is not found in any of the ancient text. The term jati is found only in grammar when they are referring to sangya, jati vachak sangya and vyakti vachak sangya. Therefore, I believe that the Vedic society was primarily a tribal society. And later on, tribes converted into castes. And today, castes are converting into class. Therefore, there has been historical transition in Indian society, but this is more related with culture, which I will deal later on. At the moment, my emphasis was on dharma or religion. From religious point of view, caste is less important than Varna, because all the texts deal with Varna and not with caste. Caste has been studied by sociologists. Varna has been studied by Indologists. Indologists are those who study India on the basis of scriptures, written text. Sociologists study Indian society on the ground, empirically. Therefore, caste is an aspect of Hindu culture. It is not an aspect of Hindu religion.
Okay. So, my other question is, what has been our source of peace and harmony in the society, whether it's a religion or the caste? Somebody say, because as we find the caste struggle now, that was not so prevalent in the medieval India or the ancient India. So the differences we find also now in religion. So violence has now taking on the religion ground, caste ground, the race grounds, different sphere of the world. But in India, by and large, the society has been peaceful. So somebody say it's because our Hindu religion that is more tolerant, teaches us to be tolerant and all that. Because of that, or the caste accommodated all the work, all the things in itself. That's why we are the peaceful in comparison to the world.
This is one of the view to which I have my own reservations. I think peace in India has been the product of dharma and not caste. Because caste did not exist in ancient India. What existed in ancient India was tribe. Caste is a later day development.
No, but during the Maurya, before that.
And today, what is the role of caste? It is dividing the Indian society. Caste is not the same today, which was the case in 1980s or 1990s. For example, the backward class movement or the Dalit movement transformed the dynamics of caste. The dynamics of caste during the freedom movement was different. The dynamics of caste during medieval period was different when Bhakti movement was going on. Therefore, one should not give very much importance to caste. Caste is one of the aspects of Indian culture. It is not an aspect of Indian dharma or Indian religion.
Okay.
Indian religion is more related with the interplay of science and culture.
Okay.
Indian religion is more a dialogue with nature, man, and supernatural.
Religion.
Indian religions
okay.
are a product of the dialogue between nature, human beings, and supernatural beings.
Okay. So, how supernatural being is acceptable in present form? Because in some days back, some years back, it was superpower was explained in terms of bhoot and other things, and devata and Bhagwan. How now you explain the supernatural power?
Even you may have supernatural power in case you practice yoga and dhyana. Even I may have supernatural power. Even the computer may have supernatural power.
Okay.
The modern science is trying to make robots which may think, which may act automatically. Supernatural power is rooted in natural power. It is only amplification of the natural power.
Okay.
And it is the product of sadhana.
So
continuous practice.
Amplification of desired frequency.
Yeah.
Not, it takes different shape like bhuta and others when it is not in the right proportion.
In India, the supernatural powers are rooted in natural laws.
Okay.
And the God Almighty is Nirgun and Nirakar. It has different manifestations. It has different manifestations in different places, different times, and different situations. And there are methods to deal with it. It is unique about the Indian religions.
Okay. So, well, friends, with these words, we would like to conclude the lecture. I thank all of you for watching the lecture. And on your behalf, I thank Dr. Amit Sharma for giving such an insightful lecture.